So unit 3 exam review is you scroll down, you will see it on here. Okay. So you need to open this and you can start. You know, you discuss up to number. Yeah, I think you did this one, right? You can see this is for all. You can use Excel chapter 7, number 9. Okay. Yeah, since last time we are here, so, right? Okay. Okay, we did number 9. Okay, for number 10 also, right? Okay. And we did half of this exam. Then you need to copy this and change the format to find out the mean, the standard deviation, and also the sample size. Okay. Yeah, so now we in number 19. Okay. If your claim is alternative hypothesis and you fail to reject the null hypothesis, right? And your conclusion would be there is not sufficient sample evidence to support the original claim, right? Okay. So the conclusion will be this one. So for fail to reject, the composition this one, but for the reject, you should pick this one here, sample data support the original claim. Okay. Okay, so let's go to the next one. Okay, at least 80% of the worker indicate that they are mildly satisfied with their job. Okay. In which of the following graph does the said region best represents the critical region? So it is say at least, right? At least that means is is greater than 82%. At least 82% is the same as greater than 82%. So that means the answer is one. Okay. So this is like greater than 80%. So the one is 82%, and the right side is for the left side is. Less than 80%, but this one is not greater than 80%. So this is to be this one, that sort of thing. So this will be the answer. Okay, so now you need to choose Number 21 is talking about confident interval. So that means this one to be chapter 8. Okay. You can see info number. Okay, well, this one is first time, so the answer is this one, yeah. Only one, yes, this one, okay. So you can see this is Excel chapter 8, number 1. So you need to open chapter 8. Number one. Right. We need to go back here. And we have to test the critical value. Right. So the critical value is, if this is 90, so you put 90, 90. So then, because we call it the computer level or alpha. And the critical value is the same as C, which is 1 minus alpha. Okay, so yeah, you need to change what is the one. The problem. Fortunately, the same because 90%. The one that you took and maybe just took. This is the sample proportion and this is the sample size. Right? So you're looking for the margin of error. Okay. For the margin of error. Plus you need to find what is the critical value. And the formula for the margin of error is the critical value, which is C2 times the square root of E hat multiplied by 1 minus B hat divided by the sample size. Okay. So in this case, the sample size is 520, the B hat is 0.5. So this is 520. Zero point. So the answer is 3 decimal, you need to use this one. So this is in 3 decimal. So the margin error will be 0.030. Okay. 0.030. Okay, so now the next one. Yeah, you can see the formula is like on the left side, you subtract the P with the margin of error, and the right side is add the P with the margin of error. Okay. Let's go here. Number 2. So first is you need to find what is the sample proportion. Okay. So in this problem is 172 divided by 500. Now for the problem, 192 divided by 600. And then this depends on the number here, or we call it the confidence level, right? And the confidence level for the problem is 95%, so we need to change it to 95/100. And this one also 95/100. No, this one is we need to change the sample size. So the critical value already have it here. The sample proportion you already have it here. Right? Now we need to put the sample size, which is 600. And in here, you need to subtract the samples proportion with the margin error. So you got this one. And on the right side, you add the sample proportion with the margin error. Okay. So this one. And you can see in three decimal, the answer is 0.283. And on the right side is 0.357. 0.357. Okay, so let's say this. You just basically just need to just do this, but you have to change to any form that you that the problem asks you to do it. Okay. Again, for this one, you're waiting for looking for the critical value. So just simply using this formula, right? So this is the formula for the critical value, right? Just like this one. So in this case is 97.5. So for your problem, you need to change this to 88%, right? So this one should be 88/100. So it is, how many decimal to put? It is decimal. Okay. So for the decimal, this one will be 1.55. Right? You can see this from the unit review, I think. Yeah, just put the extra on the thing. So actually this one is like yeah, I'm nothing here. Okay. So to find the, this is the, what do you call it? The P, right? So you can see here on the left side, this one is P minus ME. On the right side here, P plus ME, right? So if you add this to, you cancel out this one, cancel out this one, so you got to pi hat. So you can see that you got. Okay, so down here you can see this one is this one, this one, this one, and if you add it and then divide by 2, you got the p, right? So from here, okay. And to find the, and you know that me is you can find from p plus me minus p, right? So you can see the p plus me is the one on the right side. So if you subtract this, the one on the right side with the p, so you got the magic number. This one. So for our problem here, you can see you need to add and divide by 2, right? So check for 61.5. And for this one, you need to subtract the right side with the p. Okay. So what is the right side we have? 68.9, right? So this one should be 68.9. So 65.2. Okay, 65.2 and 3.7. Yeah, so yeah, so this one's the same thing, right? You add this 2 and then divide by 2, right? Okay, yeah, so maybe I can, yeah, so basically all of the problem just like that, okay? Just follow the Excel, okay? Yeah, for this one, you need to subtract this with this one. On the right side, you have to add this with this one, right? You can see from the Excel. Okay, on the right side, you subtract. On the right side, you add it. Okay. So I don't want to change it. Okay, so I'll leave it like this. And make sure for to answer this one, you have to put that the square bracket here. Okay. And you can see you can subtract on the left side, you subtract with the margin of error. This is the margin of error. So P, this is P, this is margin of error. So on the left side, you subtract it, on the right side, you add it. Okay. And number 8. Yeah, the same thing. This is sample proportion, critical value. Make sure you change this number to the number that you have. In this case, the sample size is 122, so you have to change to 122. Yeah, for this one, you're looking for Yeah, confident interval, yeah, right? Okay, so let do the same thing as the one number 20. Let's see. You can see from the ratio number 28. You can use Excel chapter 8 number 8, right? So you can see here. Yeah. Excel chapter 8 number 8. Okay. So make sure you divide this, right? It's 1%. This one. Like this. Okay. Yeah, so it's so you can see this is the same thing, right? Okay. Okay, so make sure for number. So for this one, the answer should be yeah. See, the sample should be this one. I mean, the answer. Can you see? Yeah, so yeah, so this is a certain thing, right? This should be number yeah, number 11 in the Excel, right? Related to number 31 in the problem here. So number 11 in the Excel. This one. And then just the change this. And change this one. And you need to just replace this. And automatically you can find the confident interval, right? Yeah, so that's it for this one. Okay. So you can see that. You just break this one. One prop Z into N. Yeah, for the critical value, you know, I just assume this one. Right? Okay. So number 33 will be number 13 here. Yeah, just need to with this, need to change this to 80% is the same as 0.80 or 0.8, okay? And this one is the degree of freedom. The degree of freedom is the sample size. So drop by one. Okay, so this is the degree of freedom. I need to highlight it. So we'll see it. Okay. So you will remember this. What is degree of freedom? So this sample size of drop by one. There you go. So yeah, make sure you put the degree of freedom correctly. And number 14 should be related to number 34, okay. Yeah, the same thing. This is in this one, yeah. And the number, the this case is 11 because the sample size is 12, okay? So the degree of freedom here is 12, it's 11, but the sample size is 12, okay? Yeah, margin of error, this is the standard deviation, the S, okay? And this is the sample size, okay? So let's make sure we change this one and this one. This one number, I believe it's number 34. Yeah, for number 34. Yeah, looking for margin of error. Okay, number 15, yeah, almost the same thing, right? This one is the same as number 35, okay? So looking for margin of error, okay? You just follow the formula, put the correct number, okay? Look at the correct answer. So make sure this is the degree of freedom. It is sample size 23, so the degree of freedom is 22. Okay. Yeah, make sure also you have to put this as the standard deviation and this is the sample size, which is. Okay, number 16, the same as number 56 in the problem here. Okay, so yeah, so for this one we let me see some checking number 16 in this problem, right? Okay. Yeah. So most of the student is make mistake here. Okay. So make sure this is you have to change this one. And make sure the margin of error, I mean the degree of freedom is sample size separated by 1. So in this case is 14 because the sample size is 15. So separated by 1 divided 14. And this one is the current freedom level. So you need to change to based on whatever you have here. Okay. And the margin of error. Okay, this is the S or the standard deviation, and divided by the sample size, which is 15. And here, this is the X bar minus the margin of error. Okay, so make sure you put the X bar correctly. So in this case, the X bar is 50. So put the 50 in the formula and then subtract it, margin of error, which is C2, vice versa. And on the other side, you add 50. Yeah, so this one should be 15, okay. Plus the degree, I mean the margin of error, okay. Yeah, most of the students make mistake here because it didn't see this and have to change this one, right? This is X bar separate with the margin of error. Okay. And this is X bar. Now add with margin of error. Margin of error. It's just another example, okay. So you can try it on here instead of just changing the one on here. Okay. Yeah, so this number 56. Yeah, make sure the X bar minus margin of error, the X bar minus plus margin of error. Okay. Okay, so now you need to put the confidential interval as this. Okay. So this is like the X and this is the margin of error. Okay. I mean this is X bar and this is the margin of error. Okay. Let's see here. This sounds to be this one. Right? So you can see this is the X bar, which is this one here. And this is the margin of error. We cut it from there. So make sure we have to change this one with it. You need to change this one with the one whatever you have here. So in this problem, you need to put the 17, the mean or S bar is median. So this one should be 14 and then one is the marginal variance. Okay, so this one is looking for critical value. Okay, yeah, just using the formula, what's the critical value number? Yeah, so you simply change this one, and make sure what is the sample size, yeah, in order to get the degree of freedom. So in this case, the sample size is 6, so the degree of freedom is 1. Okay. DOE, DOF, this is degree of freedom. Okay. Oh, what happened to this one? That is off. So this is the degree of freedom. You know, I need to remind you all the time. Okay, so let's go to the question number 19. This is the same as 39. So you need to put what is the S bar here and then what is the degree of freedom. Right? So it's the same thing. You need to, I think I put in the Excel here how to find that one here. So to find the X bar, you need to add them and divide by 2. So you got this one. So you have put it here. You add this 2, divide by 2. You got this one. You got the X bar. And then if you subtract the right side, with the X bar, so you got the marginal error. So you can use on this formula. Okay, let's go to the next problem. 40. Yeah, 40 is the same thing, right? You need to add this 2, divide by 2 to get the x, right? And on the right side, you subtract this with the x bar, you get the margin of error. Okay? You can see the number 19. Yeah. Okay, number 18. Number 20, you can add number 40, yeah? Same thing, right? So you add this 2 divided by 2, right? But this, but the S bar, okay? You can see here, add those 2 divided by 2, but the S bar. And then on the right side, you subtract this. And to get the margin of error, you subtract the right side with the S bar. You can see the number of 19. Yeah, so for this one, you just need to on the left side, X bar minus ME, and then on the right side, X bar plus ME. Yeah. Yeah, same thing. One number for the unit accent. Okay. You have any questions?